Hello, welcome to a new session on Python programming offered by Sifting Bytes Academy. My name is Venu, and in this video, we will learn about Python implementations and Python distributions, and also how to choose one that is right for our environment. I hope you find it interesting and informative. Let's get started. Before we proceed to install Python in our computer, we should know what exactly is a Python distribution. Let's open up the Python's official website, python.org. If you go to Downloads, the website automatically identifies our operating system and shows us a button to download and install the latest Python version. If we proceed to download and install it, then what we get is a standard Python distribution. It's called a distribution because along with the standard Python interpreter implementation, also called as CPython because it's written in C language, it is bundled with a bunch of other things packaged together and distributed for us to use. So, a distribution is more than just a simple Python interpreter. It's a package or a bundle. Standard Python distribution has all the things we need to get started with Python. It comes with a code editor called IDLE, which is very useful when we write Python code. It also comes with a very comprehensive standard library, which is good enough for most of our basic programming needs. We get a reference manual to refer to if we want to dive deeper into the language features. It also comes with many utility tools and scripts that enables us to build a full-fledged enterprise-grade applications very smoothly and efficiently. And finally, there is the Python interpreter, CPython, which is the standard implementation of the Python language. It translates the Python programs we write into machine code that's understood by the computer and executes it. An interpreter is kind of a translation software that translates programs written in high-level languages like Python into low-level language like machine code and executes it. Modern Python interpreters are very powerful and sophisticated as compared to the older generation interpreters. They come with many built-in capabilities like just-in-time compiler, which makes them very intelligent and powerful. So much so that some people prefer to call it as some kind of a hybrid translation software rather than calling it just an interpreter. Anyway, we will dive a little deeper into the architectural aspects later in the course. So this is the standard Python distribution provided for us by Python Software Foundation. Also refers to it as Core Python distribution. Remember, python.org hosts only this standard Python distribution of Python. If you are not happy with what you are getting with the standard distribution, then you can also look for alternatives. For instance, if you are not happy with just the standard implementation, that is, the CPython interpreter that comes bundled in the standard Python distribution, then you can replace it with an alternative implementation. python.org under Alternative Implementation section provides pointers for a number of alternative implementations. For example, we can replace CPython with PyPy implementation. It claims to be a lot faster in performance and also provides smoother integration with C and C++ libraries. While PyPy can be used as a drop-in replacement for CPython interpreter or as an alternative implementation, it misses out few newer features and syntax of most recent versions of Python language. That means, if you write Python programs using some of the most modern syntax, then PyPy implementation might or might not support them and might fail to interpret it. Other popular implementations are IronPython. It enables smoother integration with .NET platform. And then we have Jython, that enables better integration with Java libraries, and so on. Stackless Python is another alternative implementation. It just extends the CPython implementation and supports microthreads. It allows programmers to reap the benefits of thread-based programming without the performance and complexity problems associated with conventional threads. MicroPython is another leaner and efficient implementation of Python. It includes a small subset of the Python standard library and is optimized to run on microcontrollers and embedded systems. primarily suitable in constrained environments. And also there are many other alternative Python implementations. We just got to do a quick research before we pick one, because they all have pros and cons. In some of them, there could be a trade-off between the performance and developer productivity. Some implementations might not support the latest language features and syntax. So we got to be very careful, and only when we are absolutely certain about what we want, we can pick one after weighing in all the pros and cons. But statistically speaking, CPython is the standard interpreter or the implementation that's the most widely used one across the board. And that's what we will go with in this course. This way, we can customize our Python environment the way we want. We can also choose to use a different code editor if we want. Instead of using IDLE, the code editor that comes with the standard Python distribution, we can install PyCharm. It's an IDE specifically for Python programming language. It's a lot more sophisticated and provides code analysis, a graphical debugger, an integrated unit tester, provides integration with version control systems, and supports web development as well as data science applications. There are many other popular code editors to pick from. We can set any of them in our system and configure them to use our standard Python interpreter. The same way, if we are not happy with the standard library and packages that come bundled in the standard distribution, we can choose to install some third-party package from the huge ecosystem of Python. There is a useful tool called pip that comes with Python installation, which is a very popular Python package manager. It allows us to install and manage packages for Python. Sometimes, we might end up spending way too much time customizing our Python setup. One common case is data science. If you are someone who is interested in exploring into the field of data science, then this standard distribution bundle is not just enough. So, either we can choose to spend some good deal of time customizing it, or we can just pick another alternative distribution which better suits our needs. Python.org also provides pointers for a number of alternative distributions as well. One of the most popular ones is Anaconda. Anaconda is a distribution of Python and R programming languages for scientific computing. It's perfect for data scientists, for machine learning applications, large-scale data processing, predictive analytics, and so on. Anaconda distribution comes with over 250 packages automatically installed. In addition to that, its repository features over 8,000 open source data science and machine learning packages. There is also a small bootstrap version of Anaconda called Miniconda. This way, based on our needs, we can choose any other alternative distribution offered by third-party individuals and organizations who have repackaged CPython to include more libraries and are specialized for a particular type of applications. To summarize what we have learned till now, standard Python distribution is the Python setup, a bundle of components of Python that provide us a Python runtime environment in which we can run our Python programs. The heart and core of which is the standard Python implementation, that is, the CPython interpreter. And this is the one that we can install from Python Software Foundation's official website, python.org. And that's what we will do in the next video. But for people who want more, or who want something different than what the standard Python distribution offers, there are alternative Python distributions we can choose from, that are offered by third-party individuals and organizations. For example, Anaconda is one such alternative distribution, popular for building data science applications. It is developed and maintained by Anaconda Incorporation, which was founded by Peter Wang and Travis Oliphant in 2012. Basically, they took this standard Python implementation, that is, the CPython interpreter and the standard Python libraries, and repackaged them by including more specialized libraries, more tools and code editors that are useful for building data science applications. In addition to Python, Anaconda also provides support for R programming language, another popular language used in the field of data science. So, we get all of them automatically installed when we install Anaconda distribution in our system. We will explore more of it and set it up later in the course. Also, please note that some distributions, although very few, might use alternative Python implementations like PyPy or IronPython as the core component, instead of standard CPython and build around them. So you'll have to bear this in mind when choosing any non-standard alternative distribution of Python. That's all for now. See you in the next one. Your feedback will be enormously helpful in improvising the final shape of this course. So please subscribe to the Sifting Bytes channel and contribute any questions, comments, or suggestions in the comment section below. Thank you.